The Huawei P10 features a fingerprint sensor-laden home button, dual Leica branded rear cameras, and a metal body. The P10 Lite features none of these traits. So is this phone just trying to ride the coattails of the company's flagship, or is it a solid premium mid-ranger in its own right? So this is actually the first time we've got our hands on this device. We didn't actually see it on the show floor at NWC or anything like that. But I'm going to unbox this version for you so you know exactly what you're getting if you're looking for a, as the name suggests, lighter experience in the same vein as the flagship Huawei P10. So this has the same kind of top-loading vertical opening box as we found on like the likes of the Honor 8 and Honor 9 and a few other Huawei phones as well. I think there's Nova phones opened in the same way. So it's a nice tall, slim package here. Got this kind of blue to turquoise rainbow effect all over the place. It looks pretty good. The Huawei design, of course, so design should be a pretty prevalent part of this smartphone experience. And I've already taken the slits off, so I should just lift out. There we go. So this has been unboxed before, as I understand it, or at least the phone's been taken out, because it should come with screen protectors. That's the only thing I'm pretty sure has been touched. Aside from that, everything else is exactly the same as you get if this was an absolutely box-pressed version of the handset. So you have this nice kind of bookcase style design here. So the phone itself just slides out like that. So there is the phone. It looks pretty good on first impressions. Very glass heavy front and back. So not metal bodied like the P10 and P10 Plus, which is interesting. And actually the design looks way closer to the likes of the, not even the 2017 model, but the original P8 Lite in terms of its design, with the exception of this, obviously there's now a rear fingerprint sensor in there too, which I don't believe the original P8 Lite had. And there's also just a single camera on the back there. All the cameras struggling with the reflections. But yeah, so you have a single camera on the back rather than a dual camera as you would on the P10 or P10 Plus with what looks like a single tone LED flash too. You've got nice metal construction here. And a few other bits and bobs. I just pressed and held the power button just to see if it's got to charge. And I'll have a quick look through the software experience once it's all powered up and good to go. So back to the box. So on the left side, we have this little folder here, which has got a little diagrammatical thing suggesting it's all full of paperwork. I'm guessing quick start guide, warranty card, all that good stuff. So yeah, quick start guide in multiple languages, a little sticker about logos and certification and the warranty. And that's everything in that half. And then this half, meanwhile, has, again, kind of alludes to all of the things you'll find inside. So it's nice to see that there are some headphones in there too. And you can even see the SIM tool at the top there. So, oh, don't need to open it that way. That's not correct. Pull it this way. Oh, there we go. So we have a, so this would be wound up and bound in the same plastic wrapping as that. But it's micro USB, not USB-C. White color match cable goes alongside this guy here, which of course is the integrated charger, USB charger, and I believe it is quick charge. It's not supercharged, but it should give you some level of fast charging. Looks like a pretty nice looking premium, well built adapter there as well, so it shouldn't fall apart, which is always nice. And then you get these suspiciously AirPod like, or EarPod rather, white in earphones with an inline remote that you can see, which got a volume control, and I think that's the third button in the middle, so it's a three button remote. And it just connects via the headphone jack to the P10 Lite, which is great. The last thing is, if you pull this tab up here, the SIM tool actually comes in the box like that, and that just slides out like so. Standard Huawei SIM tool, nothing else to see there really, so you get that's all of the contents of the box. Rather than taking cues from the P10 and P10 Plus, aesthetically, the P10 Lite looks like a subtle evolution of its predecessor. You get a glass front and back with nicely rounded edges, a squared, sturdy metal frame broken up by a few antenna lines, and a rear-mounted fingerprint sensor. Like the company's other phones, picking the right colour is key to minimising the appearance of smudges and fingerprints, which are inevitable where glass-bodied handsets are concerned. We appreciate the tactile textured hardware controls too, but were hoping for the convenience and future-proofing that USB-C affords, rather than the now aging micro USB standard that the P10 Lite sports. Despite the name, the P10 Lite is not only larger and heavier than the vanilla P10, but it also packs in a bigger 5.2-inch display as well. It's arguably one of the nicest aspects of the phone though, with impressive contrast, especially from a mid-ranger with an LTPS LCD. Its full HD resolution renders text and imagery cleanly, and it prioritizes accuracy over vibrancy with regards to color. As for the audio experience, there's a single downward facing speaker behind the grille on the phone's bottom edge that pushes out clear but uneventful sound. And despite thinning down from its predecessor, you can also expect a conventional 3.5mm headphone jack in there too. Like the beefier P10s and Honor's most recent efforts, the P10 Lite sports the latest iteration of the company's Android overlay out the box, Emotion UI 5.1 running atop Android 7.0 Nougat. We've already waxed lyrical about the huge improvement 5.1 is over older iterations of Huawei's user experience, but its key tenets fall into three main areas. Firstly, the company has tidied up the interface so that it's simpler to use, plus the option of adding in an app store and a global search bar are super convenient. Secondly, the themes app and other customization options make the P10 Lite incredibly easy to personalize. Whilst the software's talents in background optimization via Huawei's Ultra Memory and Ultra Response initiatives make sure the phone feels fast and will remain snappy over its lifetime. This is the first phone we've encountered sporting the company's own Kirin 658 processor, and on paper it's comparable to Qualcomm's Snapdragon 65, the chipset powering last year's Huawei Nova and Nova Plus. It packs plenty of punch for everyday use, and paired with 4GB of RAM on the P10 Lite, seems more than comfortable sporting split-screen multitasking and running 3D games. As for storage, the UK version packs 32GB, but almost 10GB of that is occupied by the phone's firmware, which would be cause for concern were it not for microSD support up to 256GB. There's also a 3000mAh non-removable battery inside, and it's another gem. You can expect just shy of 2 days of mixed usage per charge, thanks in part to the company's smart power-saving 5.0 tech, and Huawei's 18W quick charger gives you a workday's worth of use, or just over 40%, in just 30 minutes. Sadly, Huawei didn't transpose the P10's dual signature cameras over when selecting the snappers for the P10 Lite. Versus the full-fat P10, this Lite version sports a single 12MP primary sensor with an f2.2 aperture and 1.25 micron pixels, paired with a single LED flash, whilst an 8MP autofocus effort with an f2.0 aperture sits on the front. Fire up the camera app, and the experience on offer is a nice evolution of Huawei's long-standing interface design. The main viewfinder isn't too busy, with some 13 modes just a swipe to the right and relevant camera settings always accessible by swiping left. You can download more from the mode selection screen and edit their order by tapping the pencil icon in the corner, making the experience wholly personalizable to your tastes and needs. Some of the more unique native offerings that you'll seldom find outside of Huawei's handsets include Pro Video Mode, Watermark, and All Focus, which lets you refocus shots after capture. But there are also more conventional but nonetheless useful inclusions like manual control and HDR shooting as well. Tapping the mode name near the shutter will revert you back to the standard still capture too, so no matter where you are within the camera's experience, it's easy to jump back to simple snapping without having to swipe around first. Beauty mode can be applied to subjects using either the front or back cameras, along with real-time filters that make your shots Instagram ready in an instant. Huawei has also tried to make the methods of capture as easy as possible, with a voice-activated shutter option that lets you take a photo by saying cheese or a hearty fusro da. There's also the option of touch capture, so you can tap anywhere within the viewfinder to take a picture, and ultra snapshot, which lets you snap a photo from sleep by double-tapping the volume down key. It even gives you a sleep to snap time just to show off. Essentially, the ways in which you can take a photo on the P10 Lite are many and varied, and we appreciate that. Shots typically appear accurately coloured and well exposed, with a pleasing amount of dynamic range on display, even if the resultant images look a little subdued as a result. Throwing HDR mode in on top of an already bright, well exposed image doesn't appear to make all that much of a difference, however. Despite what seems like a relatively narrow aperture and the phone's small sensor size, the main camera's low light performance is actually commendable, with low noise and only moderate grain. Detail will take a hit when shooting handheld, whilst the flash does a good job of exposing subjects in a pleasing enough manner, even if the single LED arrangement is a little too narrow when firing off. As for the more exotic features on offer, light painting in particular can be used to great effect, whilst the beauty mode actually works right through the scale, with higher settings undoubtedly looking a little heavy-handed but not turning you into an extraterrestrial as some others do. The 8MP selfie machine also offers a well-rounded experience. Color depth and detail is certainly lacking compared to the Lite's main camera, but the overall result is still pleasant, especially with such a competent beauty mode and effective screen-based flash on hand. This mid-range P10 loses out on its flagship sibling's 4K video recording, so footage tops out at full HD at 30 frames per second. Pro Video Mode lets you tweak exposure, white balance, and focus method, whilst object tracking is the only other obvious option when you dive into the settings menu. The best attribute of the P10 Lite's video recording is its autofocus. It's just so damn fast. The phone seemed perfectly comfortable as I swung in close on a metal sign before quickly panning back to a wide shot, and all the while, it kept everything looking clear. Actual image quality appears to suffer when shooting in higher contrast environments, underexposing darker areas, whilst no apparent stabilization tech seems like a significant shortcoming as well. Audio meanwhile is clear and wind noise is handled well, but the microphones also pick up plenty of background din and struggle to create clear stereo separation. Don't pick up the P10 Lite expecting the same top-tier camera experience as its flagship brethren, but at the same time, don't let the branding fool you. Whilst this handset might be light on cameras, it's certainly got ability where it counts. The Huawei P10 Lite may not look like its more powerful siblings, the P10 and P10 Plus, but it does pack the same Emotion UI 5.1 based user experience. We're going to show you how to get the best out of that software. Customizing your home screens. Those already familiar with Android will likely know that pressing and holding on a blank area of one of your home screens typically lets you add apps, widgets, change wallpapers, and more. In the case of the P10 Lite, by jumping into the dedicated home screen settings menu in the bottom right, you can also alter transition animations between different desktops, decide whether they continuously loop or not, scale grid size, and toggle badge icons for notifications. Showing or hiding the app drawer. One of the oldest gripes users had with early iterations of Emotion UI was its decision to drop stock Android's app drawer completely, forcing all of your apps to live on one of your home screens iOS style. Thankfully, the P10 Lite gives you the choice to add or remove the app drawer. By default, it's switched off, but you'll find the option to enable it again from within the home screen style section of the settings menu, where you can switch from standard to drawer to bring it back. One-handed use. Huawei's devices have offered one-handed use for generations, but for some reason it's disabled out of the box on the P10 Lite. To switch it back on, open the settings menu, scroll to the Smart Assistant submenu and tap on the one-handed UI option. Mini screen view scales the entire interface when you swipe across the navigation keys, with a tap outside the interface area to scale it back up again. Shifting keyboard meanwhile justifies the entire typing area to one side of the screen or the other. Some may also find the floating dock useful, found in the Smart Assistant menu under System Control. Better readability. The Eye Comfort feature alters the color temperature of the P10 Lite's display to allow for more comfortable viewing in darker, dingier environments. What's more, you can add an Eye Comfort toggle to the P10 Lite's quick settings in the notification shade by tapping the pencil and dragging its icon onto the lineup of active settings. As for brighter conditions, the increased readability under sunlight toggle in the phone's display settings will ensure your P10 Lite boosts its maximum screen brightness when the sun's rays pose a threat to visibility. Fingerprint sensor gestures. The rear-mounted fingerprint sensor doesn't just unlock your phone, it can be used to pull off a few extra actions too. Once you've registered a fingerprint, dive into the Fingerprint ID section of the settings menu. There you'll find all manner of options that you can toggle on or off, including the ability to swipe down in order to summon the notifications panel, and press and hold to snap a selfie when using the camera. Super useful stuff. How to split-screen multitask. Many Huawei phones have offered up split-screen multitasking for some time, but Android Nougat, which runs on the P10 Lite, now makes that feature native. You can run two apps simultaneously one of two ways. First is Huawei's hit-and-miss method, dubbed knuckle mode. Simply drag your knuckle across the center of the screen when in an app to trace a blue line, at which point the screen will split and you'll be able to pick any other open application to run alongside it. Alternatively, press and hold the app switcher key when in an app to bring up the same split-screen interface. You can also drag the blue bar to alter how much of the screen each application takes up. Power saving. The 3000 mAh battery inside the P10 Lite should be good enough to see you through to almost 2 days of use per charge depending on usage. But you can stretch longevity even further by leveraging the phone's smart power saving 5.0 skill set. Under battery in the settings menu, you'll find three important toggles. Power saving mode gives you a few extra hours of juice by minimizing background app activity, reducing visual effects and transitions, and turning off background email synchronization. Ultra power saving alters the interface to a simple black affair with low screen brightness and access to only 6 apps of your choosing, whilst the low resolution power saving toggle simply drops the resolution of the interface to draw less power in day-to-day use. If it isn't already apparent, the Huawei P10 Lite is clearly more of a refinement upon the P9 Lite than a stripped-down version of the company's P10 flagship, which is a bit of a shame. It lacks the standout features of Huawei's current top dog, and despite being well-built with a great user experience, it's not only forgettable, but it also has to take on the more affordable Moto G5 Plus, and that is no easy task. Hopefully you found our full review of the Huawei P10 Lite useful, and if you want to know more, we also have a tips and tricks video and a camera review to check out on our YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe, and you can read more on Recombu.com. Thanks for watching.